listen up. You can be anything in the world, and God we trust. An architect, doctor, maybe an actress, but nothing comes easy. It takes much practice. Like, I met a woman who's becoming a star. She was very beautiful, leaving people in awe. Singing songs, Lena Horne, but the younger version. Hung with the wrong person, got a stronger than heroin. Cocaine, sniffing up drugs, all in her nose. Could have died so young, now looks ugly and old. No fun, cause now when she reaches for hugs, people hold their breath, cause she smells of corrosion and death. Watch the company you keep and the crowd you bring, cause they came to do drugs and you came to sing. So if you're gonna be the best, I'ma tell you how. Put your hand in the air and take the vow. I know I can,
I know I can,
be what I wanna be,
be what I wanna be.
If I work hard at it,
if I work hard at it,
I'll be where I wanna be. Boys and girls, listen again. This is for grown-looking girls who's only 10. The ones who watch videos and do what they see, as cute as can be, up in the club with fake ID. Careful, for you meet a man with HIV. You can host a TV like Oprah Winfrey. Whatever you decide, be careful, some men be rapists. So act your age, don't pretend to be older than you are. Give yourself time to grow. You're thinking he can give you wealth, but so young boys, you can use a lot of help, you know. You're thinking life's all about smoking weed and ice. You don't wanna be my age and can't read and write, begging different women for a place to sleep at night. Smart boys turn them in and do whatever they wish. If you believe you can achieve, then say it like this. I know I can,
I know I can,
be what I wanna be,
be what I wanna be.
If I work hard at it,
if I work hard at it,
I'll be where I wanna be.
I'll be where I wanna
now,
be.
Go. We came to this country, we were kings and queens, never porch monkeys. There was empires in Africa called Kush, Timbuktu, where every race came to get books to learn from black teachers who taught Greeks and Romans, Asian Arabs, and gave them gold. When gold was converted to money, it all changed. Money then became empowerment for Europeans. The Persian military invaded, they heard about the gold, the teachings, and everything sacred. Africa was almost robbed naked. Slavery was money, so they began making slave ships. Egypt was the place that Alexander the Great went. He wasn't shocked that the mountains were black faces. Shot up their nose to impose what basically still goes on today, you see. If the truth is told, the youth can grow. They learn to survive until they gain control. Nobody says you have to be gangsters, hoes. Read more, learn more, change the globe. Ghetto children, do your thing. Hold your head up, little man, you're a king. Young princess, when you get your wedding ring, your man will sing, she's my queen. I know I can,
I know I can,
be what I wanna be,
be what I wanna be.
If I work hard at it,
if I work hard at it,
I'll be where I wanna be. Save the music, y'all. Save the music, y'all. Save the music, y'all. Save the music, y'all. Save the music.
Straight down the street.
That's where we have to get it. We would just try. Let's see what we write.
He's gonna film a little bit because we're doing a documentary. Is that okay?
Oh, sure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now the conversations.
We were driving. We were driving. What street was that? We were driving down. We seen the big old ball, and we stopped up. And
we ride on Crenshaw.
Okay.
Crenshaw.
And 50th Street.
Yeah.
50th. And there was a big old wall, and so we got up.
In the beginning, and then there's this breath, and it's Kimberly.
And they had this little thing. It says, "All men are created equal." I'm like, "No, we not." All white. That, we weren't even considered a people when that was done.
Right, right. That was the American white man having dialogue with the British white man, where they had a family dispute, where these people said, "Listen, taxation. We're being taxed, and we don't have no representation in the Hall of Parliamentary. And you know, we feel that this is a form of tyranny. And without representation, we feel that this is an issue." So they stood up, the founding fathers of this white nation, George Washington, Patrick Henry, and those that established this nation after taking it from the original inhabitants, the Indians. They said, listen, taxation without representation is tyranny. Give us liberty or give us death. That sparked the Revolutionary War. But it didn't have nothing to do with black people because we were still, the Emancipation Proclamation wasn't even signed until 1863.
And
he was
right.
saying,
right.
he was saying that all white men are created equal.
That's what he was
we
saying.
Hold these truths to be self-evident.
She just
you know, that there are certain inalienable rights such as life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Well, then you were alienating black people from life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. But we weren't considered a people in your eye. Okay, well then it's nothing we need to talk about. It's an all-out war.
They don't teach
it's
that in school.
It's an all-out war. Well, brother, this is why you, the first school is the home. See, this have to be taught in the home and in the institutions.
That's right.
Where the curriculum speaks to the truth of what our sojourn has been here in America. No, they're not going to teach this in a school. If a person don't treat you right, what makes you think they're going to teach you right?
Right.
You see what I'm saying? Yeah. They fed us a steady diet of lies from the womb to the tomb, from the cradle to the grave. So therefore, we cannot expect our oppressor to be our oppressor and our benefactor at the same time. He's not obligated to teach us. That's not his responsibility. He has reduced us from pyramid builders to project dwellers, from the uppermost to the guttermost. Okay, now that's what he has done, and he's done a good job at it. But it's our responsibility to step back on the stage of human history and begin to define life in our own image and interest. We have to do that. We can't expect him to concede on the moral issue of doing right because right is right to do right. He's not going to do that.
It's not him to do right.
History has shown that he's disagreeable to live with in peace. So therefore, the less contact, the less conflict. Separation solved the problem. When he couldn't get justice from his white brothers, he said, this is the first thing we got to do is separate. So when he went over here and separated and declared his independence, he said, now listen, here's the line of demarcation. We don't want no physical engagement if necessary, but if you're just going to bring us the noise, we'll just fight you the best way we can. So give us liberty or give us death. We never told the white man that. We never let him know that we want freedom or just put us all in the unknown universe. And if you can do that, all that means that we weren't supposed to be here from the beginning. If you can put all people of color, black, brown, red, and yellow, into the unknown universe, like you claim to have the ability to do, then go ahead and do that. And if you can do that, you can have this rock to yourself. You can have this planet to yourself. But you know that you didn't put us here, and you know that if you make us disappear, this is my gallery. If I put this book here, I put it here for a reason. Mm-hmm. Now, if you make it disappear, now what has to happen? You have to deal with who put it here.
Right.
I'm the owner of this gallery. I'm the owner of this book. I put it here, and I put it here for a reason. Now, you made it disappear. Now, you got to confront me. The white man knows that somebody put black people in the universe, and it wasn't him. So if you make us disappear, now you got to deal with whoever put us here. Now, we're going to fight you the best way we can now. But he knows that black people are here, and I didn't put them here. And if I make them disappear, then ultimately I got to deal with whatever force and power put them here. Well, let's force the confrontation. That's what King was doing. King was moving up on them. That's what Malcolm was doing, you know, agitating for freedom, justice, and equality. And since that irritates you, then get rid of all of us. And if you can do that, all that means that black people weren't supposed to be in the universe, and you became so irritated with our presence, you decided to make us disappear.
I can't do it.
All right, now, let's see if you can do that. But don't leave one of us living, if you can do it. But you know that you didn't put us here. For the most part, you think that we didn't put ourselves here, and you know that if you make us disappear, you got to deal with whoever put us here. Well, I'm going to force the confrontation because we're going to constantly irritate you. Until you concede and allow justice, freedom, and equality to be the order of the day, or get rid of all of us. Now, if you can do that, now you're going to have to deal with whoever put us here. And you know you can't do that. And we're going to force that hand, though, because we're going to constantly irritate you.
So in order for us to become a sovereign nation, what needs to be done?
What did he do? He just made a declaration. What did the white man? He just said, listen, taxation without representation is tyranny. Give us liberty or death. All right, now, if he took that position based upon economics, then we are morally in our in the right to take it based upon our lives being at stake. Trayvon Martin.
Yeah.
Look at Oscar Grant. Mm-hmm. He's killing us daily. He's auctioning our lives off daily. See, and we haven't confronted him in that manner. See, it's going to get down to a hostile blood struggle at the end of the day. See, it's going to get down to a hostile blood struggle. We're trying to pretend that it ain't going to get that way. It's going to get that way. He's going to force it. Because when he see you, when he sees the pendulum of time swinging in our direction, as it is doing, then he's going to be more aggressive in his efforts to make us disappear. So it's going to get to a blood struggle, a hostile blood struggle.
What are those FEMA camps that they have going on now? They have those FEMA camps. You go in, those old train stations and stuff. They have actual places. You go in a gate, videotape. Well, you have a camp up there. You go in, you can't come out.
Those are hidden concentration camps that can be converted at any point in time of detention centers.
Yeah.
You see, for any urban uprising, we have the ability to contain, cordon off the community, and restrain any dissidents for internal security reasons.
You know what they call them? Terrorists.
Yes. Well, truth terrorizes the white man.
They
terrorize.
They can name anything a terrorist.
But where's that book? Now, if this is not terrorism in its fullest, then don't tell me anything about terrorism. Terrorism, sister. This is terrorism right here. Mm-hmm. You see? And this type of terror has never been expressed to the world. Now, when the white man talks about terrorism, look at the atrocities that he's inflicted upon black people. This is the apex of evil. Now, if we're not dealing with a terrorist in terms of this Caucasian, then you go get me someone that whose evil has run parallel to the white man here in America.
Oh, no, the brother ain't got no
tea.
Ain't got no pies up in here.
See, so,
you know. Man, all that truth right there. That's, picture speaks more than 1,000 words when it comes to that.
And we're direct descendants of this experience. We're direct descendants. Direct descendants. We don't know the damage that this type of misery has caused psychologically
on
the black people. Mm-hmm. See what I'm saying? This is this type of a murder of people simply because they're black.
Right, right.
See? Simply because they're black. And why? Because he knows that we are the original people, and he knows that.
You reflect the image of God.
Absolutely
too
correct.
Much.
He knows that.
And you know what?
See, he knows that.
My mother and my father, I never heard this information from them. When I was growing up in New York, Malcolm X was bad. Martin Luther King. Staten Island.
Yeah, I'm 116th Lenox Avenue.
Okay. And so so we never heard this. But now I'm hearing it now because of this, they were quiet. Because they didn't want the same things to be happening to them.
Right.
And I was just talking to somebody, they said, in New York, I said, I remember the water fountains.
Mm-hmm.
You know, black only, and they said, and I remember going to the little local church, and I'm, as a little girl, wondering, why all of us up here in this balcony? And I'm looking down over the balcony of this church. Somerville, give me a Bible, and I'm hungry. These white people coming over to these different continents, giving these little black kids these Bibles, and then leaving them. And then you take all my land. You give me the Bible, I close my eyes, and you take my land.
Yes. That is the intellect. That's to quiet your consciousness to make you non-resistance when he comes to put his aggressive move down and to take the raw material and the resources and the land. So he gives you a belief. See, he has to quiet you through a teaching. Basically, it's intellectualizing you out of your originality.